many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer.
Number one is to always carry a tent with you. They are extremely invaluable, and all but Lancaster, Pat Navy, Prototype, Sharps, Hartford, and Spitfire struggle to penetrate its walls. The white tent can also be shot out of through the back without being able to be shot back. The camp bed is a cheap version of the tent. With the ability to sleep and gain health, it is very useful, though the tent may be more practical in defense. It costs $400 and sells for $140. Camp tents are extremely useful for gaining quick health when you are in need of a quick health boost. It's a camp bed with a small tent around it for protection. Camp tent 1 and 2's only differences are color and shape. Both camping tents cost $1,200 and sell for $420. I'm telling you guys, buy a tent and carry it. Number 2 is that you can fly your horse. I wouldn't abuse this one too much, like using the horse as a sniper position or anything. You could get in trouble. I only mess around with this when I'm chilling with the homies. It's fun to play with, but not abuse. To fly your horse, shoot it and push it onto its side. Straddle its saddle until both legs bend. Simply wait for the horse to stand and you will fly. Number 3 is that you can use a lasso to scale walls faster. Simply equip your lasso and move side to side, jumping when you need to. This allows you to scale it much faster than if you were on foot. Just another good reason to always keep a lasso handy. Back when this was first discovered, it was said that you could get banned for it. This trick is great for taking a fort if you don't have $150 for the dynamite needed to blow open the doors and don't have a build tool but want to keep the doors intact. Using the lasso trick from number 3 will ensure your success. Forts are great for a lot of things, but that will be for another video. Press Q to raise your fists, and all at once you will press the roll and jump button at the same time. If done correctly, you will land into the fort and be able to take it. Use this at your own discretion. I don't know if you can get banned or not. It's a rumor. What I do know is that I'm just an entertainer, so enjoy. Number 5 is to remember to use wall penetration to your advantage. If your gun is strong penetration as listed on the wikia or greater, you can usually shoot through walls and sometimes even doors. I've used this to pepper an area where even though I cannot see my target, I can still hit him. ADF 2309, and I tested the penetration depth of the auction guns. Spitfire, Proda, Lancaster, and Pat can all punch through a single wall. We tried up to 3 layers of walls, but 3 was where every bullet was stopped. Maybe the Hartford, which has the best penetration in game, stands a chance. I'm too broke to find out right now. I will further conclude that every single one of the auction guns, aside from the guycots that we didn't bother testing, made it through even 2 layers of wall. You aren't as safe indoors as you thought that you were, apparently. Number 6. While we were trying to get the Fort Henry footage, we were injured many times. I set up my trusty tent nearby for quick health. The tent counts as a bed here, but there are beds that are overlooked all over the entire map. Even in the ruined fort in Tribal Forest and in Fort Henry and Spencer. You can find beds everywhere, and they are literally laying around waiting to be used for quick health recovery. Number 7 is the hidden pixel. Over by the limestone quarry, there is a sacred object that you pass by probably every single day. This place is often visited without an afterthought. But there, amidst it all, is a tiny pixel that you can climb upon. Makes you wonder what else you may have missed out there, huh? Number 8. You don't need a trading ticket to trade. You heard me right. You can trade without one by going to the reservation camp in Tribal Forest and sitting at this table in the saloon. Despite what most people think, you need the ticket to buy black market items. But you don't need it to give your friend a special auction gun or item. 670 plus hours in this game and I'm just now finding this out. The more you know. When we think of healing during combat, we foolishly think we need to carry bandages. We go and buy them for $100 at a time. What if I told you there were other healing items? There are two ways to gain health outside of bandages and sleeping. Cactus and cooked meat. You heard me right, boys. Both are entirely free. While the meat seems to last longer, it drops and death and is costing you $75 each time you use it, when you could have sold it instead. It also drops on death, like cactus. It's best to carry only a few of each at any given time so that your enemies don't get a panada every time you die. Number 10 is carry bandages. Bandages can be bought at captured forts or from role-playing doctors you see around the map. It is by far one of my favorite roles to play, as I always randomly make money by someone buying a bandage from me. This is footage from ADF and I trying to do a Lancaster review and these guys decided to try something. There were several times when they could have killed me, but thanks to Nurse Ada who sold me like 40 bandages off screen days ago, I lived to tell the tale. Bandaged is the best healing buff, activated by using a bandage or being bandaged by a doctor. It quadruples recovery amount to 4%. The effect lasts for 10 seconds and heals 100% plus 10 health per second. If you can't find a doctor, capture a fort and fill your bank with bandages. Unlike the previous meat and cactus, bandages can be stuck on the hotbar for use. Well guys, that does it. That was 10 tips and tricks from the old noob, Goob. Thanks for being the best fans a person could ask for. And I will see you in the next adventure in the Wild West. Stay safe out there friends, there is a bandit around every corner.
I'm lonesome but happy. Rich but I'm broke and the good Lord knows the reason. I'm just a cowpoke. I drift with the wind. No one cares where I go.